What's going on, guys? Balkan Architect here, and in today's video we're going to be talking about adding rebar to complex shapes or complex concrete forms inside of Revit. So when it comes to adding rebar, you're not limited to just kind of regular rectangular straight columns and beams. You can actually add rebar to more complicated shapes. And in this video, I'm just going to be showing you exactly how and all of the little tips and tricks that go along with that. Now, if you want to learn more about exactly this topic, concrete structures and rebar, so reinforced concrete structures, I actually have a course on that topic. So on my website, balkanarchitect.com, I'm going to be leaving a link to it just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. There I have a lot of different courses, but one of those is exactly that, a course on concrete structures in Revit, and it takes you kind of from beginning to end, learning everything you need to know to get started creating your own reinforced concrete structures. So if you're interested in that, check it out. Also, you can find a template for exactly reinforced concrete structures. Now, this template has been created by a colleague of mine. He's actually an expert in rebar inside of Revit, and he has developed this template by working on several kind of large commercial projects, so it has been kind of proven in the field. So if you want to check that out, I'm also going to be leaving a link to that in the cards above. Okay, so now without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And as you can see, here we are at the home page of Revit. So let's go here to new, and then for the template file, just so everybody can follow along, I'm just going to be using the default kind of construction template, the metric version, and then I'm just going to click OK. Obviously, if you're using Imperial, go with that. Okay, now once we're here in Revit, let's first create the form. So for the form, I'm not going to go with one of the basic forms like beams and columns. I'm going to be creating my own form, and for that, let's go here to component and then model in place. So when I select that, I have to set up the category. So for the category, you actually want to pick the correct one. You cannot just go with whatever you want, and you cannot use the generic one. You want to use a structural category. So either go with structural columns, structural foundations, and structural framing. In this case, because this is in a column, I'm just going to go with structural columns. And then I'm just going to click OK. So the name can be as is, and then let's do this as a blend. So I'm just going to click here on a blend, go with a rectangle, and then let's create a small rectangle here for our column, something like that. Okay, so we have the bottom of it, let's go to the top, and then for the top, let's go with something like this. So this is obviously something that that's very out of the ordinary. You don't see these types of columns often, so it's a little bit of a weird shape, and I'm just going to be showing you how to add rebar to this. So I'm just extending it a little bit. Let's actually go to the south elevation here, and let's extend it all the way to level 2. There we go, perfect. We have our kind of oddly shaped column. So now let's add rebar to this shape. So what you want to do is just finish this model, then you want to select it, and because we have set it up with the correct structural category, now when we select it on the modify tab, here we have a reinforcement panel and we have the rebar tool. So when you click on that, it's going to give you a little warning. We don't have any hooks for our shapes, that's okay, but we also don't have any shapes loaded in. So let's load those in. Click yes. And then here, I'm just going to go back for a moment. So here, as you can see, this is just the metric library. If you go down to structural rebar shapes, you open that up, and then you can just hold the shift key, select the first one, the last one, click open, and that's just going to be loading in all of those shapes inside of Revit. So once you have the shapes loaded in, then you can get started modeling this or modeling the rebar for this kind of oddly shaped concrete column. So here you have placement methods. It can be by sketch or freeform rebar. You want to go for freeform rebar. Then you have the distribution type, and now you have aligned or surface. In this case, we want to align it to a surface, so let's just go to surface. And then here we have the option for placement. So first, just look at the cursor and see how it has the select host surface. So you just want to follow that. So if it says select host surface, you just want to select the host surface. In this case, that's this surface here. Then we have the option to select the start surface. So you just click on that and then you click here to select the start surface. So that's where the set of the rebar is going to start, and then the end. So just click here, select the end surface, which is going to be this side here. And there we go. Perfect. Now, finally, also, I like to add the layout. So not a single, I'm just going to go with a fixed number and then let's go with 5. Click finish. And it's going to generate that rebar here. Hit the escape key a few times. And now when they select the rebar, let's just make sure that this is set to final level of detail. And then for the rebar selected, go to properties panel, view visibility states, and just check on view as solid, just so we can see it as solid rebar. Perfect. So as you can see, this rebar is perfectly following the shape of this column. So it's just following that surface here. So you can do the same thing on all sides or on just a couple of sides, or you can have one kind of in between, whatever you want. You can also uncheck the first one and the last one if that's something that you need to do. And then you can also play with the layout here if you want as well. Okay, so for now we have these. So let's do the more complicated part here, and that's add the stirrups. So that's the rebar that kind of goes all the way around and holds the column in place. So for that, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to add first a reference plane that we're going to use for placing that stirrup or for modeling that stirrup. So for that, let's go to the south elevation. You want to find the column, zoom in. And then let's go here to, let's see, okay, I don't want rebar. I just want to add a simple reference plane, just like that at the bottom. And you also want to name it. So let's call it A. Okay, so we have this rebar in place. And now let's go to the 3D view. And then in the 3D view, what we're going to be doing now is, again, select this, go to rebar. And now let's go to sketch rebar. And again, we have to select the column, and then we also want to set the work plane. So I'm just going to set the work plane from not associated to our reference plane A that we have placed here. So that's the one on the bottom that they have just placed. Then you want to click OK. And now you can see it kind of highlighted here. And it's actually just showing you the boundary of that where you can place that rebar. So it's actually just showing you kind of the rebar cover for that particular plane. So let's go into level 1, and I'm just going to create a simple rectangle here. So just like that, and then hit finish. Go to the 3D view. So this is what we have. Hit the escape key a couple of times. And then again, let's go here to view visibility states and make it as a solid one. Okay. Hit apply. Perfect. Now you can see we have a clash here, and we can actually modify this rebar if we want. I actually show that in a course. It's a little bit complicated, so I'm not going to cover it now, but it is covered in the course. If you get a course, you will learn that, so don't worry about that. Now how do we adjust this so we can see it throughout the whole column, because obviously we want to see stirrups all the way up to the top? Well, it can actually do that by going here and checking on the varying rebar set. So just check that on. And then the layout, let's change it from single to maximum spacing. And let's set that to something like 300 millimeters. And this is what we have. As you can see, it's perfectly following the shape of this oddly shaped column. So that's how you create these stirrups. And then also you can select them, and if you want to move them, or if you want to kind of readjust them, have perhaps multiple sets or something like that, you can do that as well. But the important part is it is going to follow that shape. And there we go. So this is how you create this kind of rebar for kind of odd or interesting shapes inside of Revit. I hope you have enjoyed this video, and as I said, if you want to check those courses, the course or any of my other courses, you can find that on my website. If you want to get this project file or any of my other Revit project files, you can find those on my Patreon page, which I'm going to link up again in the description of this video, and then also up in the cards above. There I have over 400 Revit project files, and I'm adding more as I create these videos and courses. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.